Hello everybody and welcome back. So today we are going to learn about how to fetch data from database to our Bellator application. So the database that I'm using right now is MySQL Server 2019. This is developer edition. You can download it freely if you don't have already installed in your PC, and it is developer edition is always free for learning and development purposes but not for production. So I will use Entity Framework Core to bring in the data from database to my Bellator application, and almost every version of SQL Server is supported. Around after version 2000 or 2005, all databases are supported. All versions of SQL Server are supported. So if you don't have enough knowledge about SQL Server or how to query SQL Server or how to use SQL Server, I also have uploaded so many videos on SQL Server on my YouTube channel that you can explore and find out the playlist for SQL Server videos, and everything is available related to querying databases there. Okay, the database structure is this, that I have these three tables right now, books, cities and countries. For now in this video we'll work with books, and let me show you its structure. The columns here, and I have simply book title. I have book ID, the identity. This is unique column, unique number for every record. And this is book title, description, date published, is available in stock, the price of book, who is the author, and what's the email of author. So we'll bring all this information from this database table to our Bellator application here. This is a simple Bellator server-side application. Right now, I'm not discussing to interact with database from a WebAssembly application here. I'll just use Bellator server application. So this is a simple application I've just created, and let me show you its output. I'm pressing Control F5. Let's see the output. Meanwhile, don't forget to subscribe. Don't forget to press the bell icon. Okay. Here we are, and this is a simple default index page. Okay, this page will utilize to bring in the data. So this page is residing inside pages index. Here we'll bring our data. So to bring in the data, let's first create the table. So there goes my table. Okay, the simple HTML, because Bellator uses bootstrap layout by default. So here is a new row that I'm going to create. If you don't know about bootstrap layouts, you should Google for them, but that is very simple. Okay, here I have created a new div, a new row with class row, and I'll utilize 10 columns for this table. This is the how many columns actually. Bootstrap uses 12 column layout, a grid of 12 columns. So from those 12 columns, I'm utilizing 10 for my this table. Okay, and here this is my table. I have applied a table class, the default bootstrap class, and this is my table header with these five columns: book title, publish, price, author and author email. These will be the five columns. Okay, so what I'm going to do here is, and here goes my body. If at this section I will render the records fetched from database. So let's see the output. I'm saving the page and hit the refresh at this point. Without any rows in it, let's replace this section as well. For that, come here. We don't need this line. We also don't need this HR. Let's convert this HR into a simple BR. Okay, and specify the headings books. Okay, books. Okay. Now what we need to do first, to use Entity Framework inside our project, we need to install the NuGet packages. To do that, come into Package Manager console, and we need to write the line. Okay, the first package that we need to install is Microsoft Entity Framework Core.SQL Server. Okay, if you don't know about Entity Framework or new to ASP.NET Core development, you can refer to my Entity Framework Core tutorials. I'll cover everything about bringing the data from Entity Framework to your application in a separate tutorial. But the command is simple. So this was the first command we used to install the package Entity Framework Core.SQL Server to interact with SQL Server. And the next thing that we need to install is the tools we use to write scaffolded entities. So what is the scaffolding? A DB context is that I'm going to explain you here. I will write a simple command, scaffold DB context. Let me write caps. It is case insensitive. You can write a small, capital, or a combination of both. Okay, scaffold DB context. Just I'm capitalizing the first letter of each word to make you better understand this scenario. Okay, then I'll place my connection string, and after that I will specify the package microsoft.entity-framework-core.sql-server. Okay, the next thing is the output directory, that in which directory you want to generate the output of classes. Okay, the directory that I want is models. I don't have models directory here inside my solution explorer, so this output folder will be created. The third thing is that I want to mention here is tables. I will specify the table books. The reason is if I don't specify this attribute here, all the tables from this database, from the given database, will be generated inside my entity framework that I don't want for now. I want to generate entity classes only for books tables. That's why I'm specifying exclusively that I want entity class generated only for this table. Okay, now let's complete this part, the connection string. My server is local. Indicate that I'm using a local server. It's not necessary to provide username password when I'm using the Windows account, which is authenticated, which has authorization to into your SQL Server. So I'll just write trusted connection to true, and very important, database that I'm going to use is testdb. Okay, let me make sure the database that I'm using is testdb. And I am not specifying all the tables there. I have exclusively specified that I want entity classes generated only for books. Okay, so the command is complete. Let's press enter to generate our entities or the entity DB context classes. Build succeed. Okay, let's wait for our models folder appear over here. There we go. Here is our models folder, and I, as per my usage of attribute tables, I only got books entity generated inside our models. Okay, so this is the class that's mapping the columns to this table. Book ID, title, description, publish date, is available, price, author, email, and here book ID, title, description, publish date, of type date, is available, of type boolean, price, of type integer and string, and author email are of type string. So the everything is mapped to my table, and this is the DB context which will communicate with the database, and it uses this entity's details to communicate with the table. So now simply just call this DB context reference inside our page here. What we need here is, first of all, we will using attribute models, because our class resides in the models namespace, models. Okay, number one. Number two, let's embed a code block. And inside this code block, I will just simply create the object test db context db equals to new test db context. Simple. Okay, now next, what we want here, we need an object of type books. For that, I will write private list of type Books. Okay. Of type books here and books. Okay. Now the third thing that I need here is I will override protected override on initialize. This is a function that is called when our page initializes. Okay, I don't need to override this space on initialized over here, but inside here, inside this function, I will simply write books equals to db dot books dot to list. Okay, we don't need to specify the type here because it will by default be converted into books type. But you'll notice one thing, I have made an object of database context directly inside my component of Blazor component. This is not recommended. We should create a data access layer class inside the models, and there I should call all this database related stuff. But for now, just for the understanding, we are using this approach. Now we will further in the same this video move this code into data access layer. Okay, so now till now we have received all the records from this db.books inside our this object of type books, list of type books. Okay, and here the last thing, let's use a for each. Okay, for each var book in books. Okay, for each var book, this is our local variable for this books here. Okay, and start the parent, not parenthesis, the body brackets, start the body brackets and close here. Okay, now we'll traverse through each book inside this books. Okay, the first thing I want to include here, now I'll use this local variable book dot book title, simple. Okay, at the red book dot, the second thing is let me see, book title, publishing date, published date, and price. The fourth one is author, and the fifth one is, let me make a copy of this cell. Okay, a new TD and author email. That's it. I think we are done with all our requirements. Everything looks fine, perfect. Let's save our page and press Ctrl F5 to run the application. Okay, there we go. Here all are our records displayed from the database. We had two records, Microsoft Visual C Sharp and exam reference book. Okay, Microsoft Visual C Sharp step by step, and the book of exam reference 70483, the exam reference for C Sharp programming. We haven't displayed description, so it's not displayed inside here. So that's it. We have retrieved data, but let's do one more thing. This is not a good approach, I already told you. Let's create a separate class here inside models, add a new item, create a class, a simple class with name DAL, data access layer, DAL, data access layer, add, and inside this DAL, I also need to include, I don't need to include because we are already in models folder. Models namespace, so all things of models are local to us here. So what we need to bring in, we'll remove these lines from here. I don't need to create db context object inside my data access layer. Here we'll specify inside my index. Okay, what we'll do is now, okay, I have just created a class. Okay, I have just created a class, and what I'm going to do is I'll first bring in this line. I'll remove this db context object line from here, and I'll put it inside my data access layer class. Okay, the next thing that I want is I will write a public function to of type list of type books with name get books. Okay, it doesn't take any argument but returns. What does it return? It returns this line of code. Okay, it returns a list of books. That's it. Okay, books with capital P. Perfect. Now this is a simple code for my data access layer. What we need to do here is we have two options. Now either we can create an object of data access layer DL equals to new data access layer, and over this data access layer we can simply call DL.getBooks. There won't be any difference in our output, everything will remain same, but the thing is we are not going to create the object of database context inside our component. So this is a bit better approach, but the more better approach is that you call the data through HTTP client from web APIs, because if I'll move this component into WebAssembly, this approach will be broken, because WebAssembly runs inside the context of client. So this work is complete. Let's control F5 and let's check the output for now. In the next session we are going to create cut operation. Okay, through cut operation we'll insert the data inside our database, we'll retrieve the data, we'll delete the data. For now, thank you very much.